have an injunction and we are going into court tomorrow morning to fight this illegal, unconstitutional injunction. All we say to America is be true to what you said on paper.
This is Ned Brooks inviting you to Meet the Press. Our guest today on Meet the Press is Dr. Martin Luther King, Jr., who led the Civil Rights March from Selma to Montgomery, Alabama. Dr. King, who was the winner of the Nobel Peace Prize, is president of the Southern Christian Leadership Conference. He is in San Francisco, where he delivered a sermon this morning for Bishop Pike at the Grace Cathedral.
There's no respect for the fact that this is Dr. King. This is somebody that's going to have a national holiday name for him. This is another nigger going to jail.
So he used the time in jail to respond. That was the so-called letter from the Birmingham jail.
He was so upset that he had to tune out the whole rest of the world to write this letter.
My dear fellow clergymen, I came across your recent statement calling my present activities unwise and untimely. I cannot sit idly by in Atlanta and not be concerned about what happens in Birmingham. Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. We are caught in an inescapable network of mutuality, tied in a single garment of destiny. Whatever affects one directly affects all indirectly.
Just happy to see white people, brown people, black people from all parts of the country making their way to Washington and coming to bring our message, which we had been crying in the wilderness for a long time.
I was just a little speck sitting out on the lawn, and I can't honestly say to you that I realized the historic significance of that event.
At this time, I have the honor to present to you the moral leader of our nation, Dr. Martin Luther King, Jr.
And the architects of our republic wrote the magnificent words of the Constitution and the Declaration of Independence. They were signing a promissory note to which every American was to fall heir. It is obvious today that America has defaulted on this promissory note insofar as her citizens of color are concerned. When we let it ring from every village and every hamlet, from every state and every city, we will be able to speed up that day when all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing in the words of the old Negro spiritual, free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last.
Martin had a great love for his family. People think it's glamorous to do all this traveling, you know, but not when you travel under a terrible, high-pressure schedule. So your life becomes turbulent, and it's not your own. You belong to the people. You belong to God, and your family has to share that ownership, as painful as that may be.
All right. Bonnie.
Yeah.
I am the mother with six children. I live on a plantation in an old piece of house. They don't know what else to get a good meal. We go working Miss Ann's house for $2 a day. If we don't want to do that, she tell us, well, you got to move. See, where you going to go to? You don't have nowhere to go to.
That's where the Poor People's Campaign started. Martin Luther King says he's absolutely convinced that the rest of the world needs to hear the testimony of these people.
I know all of you are studying hard and you're just doing fine in school, and I'm glad to see you.
And it didn't cost the nation one penny to integrate lunch counters.
Well,
it didn't cost the nation one penny to guarantee the right to vote. But now we are dealing with issues that cannot be solved without the nation spending billions of dollars and undergoing a radical redistribution of economic power.
Yeah.
This thing started with two garbage men who were crushed in the back of a garbage truck, along with the garbage, because they were not allowed to seek shelter in white neighborhoods in Memphis.
When a public official orders a group of men to get back to work and then we'll talk, and treats them as though they are not men, that's a racist point of view. And no matter how you dress it up in terms of whether or not a union can organize, it's still racism. For at the heart of racism is the idea that a man is not a man.
All labor has dignity.
Yeah.
But you are doing another thing. You are reminding not only Memphis, but you are reminding the nation that it is a crime for people to live in this rich nation and receive starvation wages.
Would you sing We Shall Overcome with me, please?
We've got some difficult days ahead, but it really doesn't matter with me now, because I've been to the mountaintop. I don't mind. Like anybody, I would like to live a long life. Longevity has its place, but I'm not concerned about that now. I just want to do God's will. And He's allowed me to go up to the mountain. And I've looked over and I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you, but I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land. So I'm happy tonight. I'm not worried about anything. I'm not fearing any man. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord.
We were standing out in the courtyard. I was telling him, it's getting cold, and you've had a cold. You need to bring your top coat. And he was, you know, wondering whether he really wanted to bring a coat. Next thing you know, I thought a firecracker had gone off or something, until I looked up there and I saw that he wasn't there. And I thought he was clowning, because he'd been so playful and happy and clowning.
Loud, real loud shot. And
when I heard somebody holler, "Oh, Lord." And then I turned around and went back to where he was, and he had fallen backwards.
I have some very sad news for all of you, and I think sad news for all of our fellow citizens and people who love peace all over the world. And that is that Martin Luther King was shot and was killed tonight. Remember?
When white America killed Dr. King, they had absolutely no reason to do so. He was the one man in our race who was trying to teach our people to have love, compassion, and mercy for what white people had done. When white America killed Dr. King, she declared war on us. The rebellions that have been occurring around the cities of this country is just lights up to what is about to happen. We have to retaliate for the death of our leaders. The execution of those deaths will not be in the courtrooms. They're going to be in the streets of the United States of America.
My husband often told the children that if a man had nothing that was worth dying for, then he was not fit to live. He said also that it's not how long you live, but how well you live. He knew that this was a sick society, totally infested with racism and violence, that questioned his integrity, maligned his motives, and distorted his views, which would ultimately lead to his death. And he struggled with every ounce of his energy to save that society from itself.
We shall overcome someday. We shall live in peace. We shall live in peace someday. Oh, deep in my heart, I do believe we shall live in peace someday.